Yeah.
The GP ulti is a tiny bit nullified. I would like to see the lane normally though, because I think Morgana, Sivir walk over Jhin, Alistar. I think there's nothing they can do in lane.
You can do standard lanes, have strong 2v2, right, or you can do lane swap and play around GP ult.
But level 1, you can trade equally. In addition to having corruption plot, it actually puts you ahead. That's exactly what happened.
There's a party in the bot lane, which is really the top lane. 2v2, Shook.
Teleport
goes up,
coming.
Comes back down. Gamsu going quite low. There isn't the teleport. Now it finally comes. Very, very late on this one as Spirit realizes the game is up for him, but he can't get away. Another cocoon, and that's a double kill for Shook.
And what a fantastic start here for Vitality. Everything they need to go right is happening. He's going to walk over to Pink Ward right now. Gamsu has to disengage here, go to the wall, but gets
Twisted Advance. Shook actually bailing out though. He's just going to clear the Pink Ward.
They can match TP for TP, Cabo versus Gamsu, but then they can either send Nuketuk in himself or his ultimate.
Playing a bottom side, TP coming in. Nuketuk is here, as we talked about in side lane, but there is backup.
Good flash.
Slow setup, but the flash is on, and now Spirit goes in. They knock him up and try to take down the Gangplank. Everyone leaves him for dead there, and it's Reckless with the kill.
Coming in so you can TP behind it. Nuketuk has to be careful here.
Oh, barrel, it's gonna knock him back, and Reckless speeding himself up, but there's a teleport coming in. And now it's 2v2 with Cabo Shard double timing onto Spirit. Reckless says, see you later.
I mean, it's actually surprising how bad Fnatic is playing against Teleport. They, in the other games, they had double TP, and they could do these plays and have this advantage, but like...
Why just walk through this?
You're walking straight into a lane again where double TP is available.
You can see it in his kill participation this game, that big, big play coming up earlier in the bottom side.
Kill the Scuttler?
They did.
And they end.
They're about to nail the Baron bait here. TP coming in.
Oh, boom. Klai, all of a sudden, half his health is gone. Unbreakable will, but they've got the ignite on him. They just want to finish him off. He's going to get the pulverize onto Kasing, and he flashes right over the wall, but Yharnam follows him.
Jukes.
To his death.
So look at Kamisar, too. He was holding the flash, like, do I?
He has cleanse. I don't want to do it, but kind of want to get into the fight. He couldn't join. Might be another fight happening, though.
Oh, the barrel. They're going to knock Cabo Shard in. And the hook from Gamsu pulls him back. But Spirit, look at that damage they're dishing out. Already on the back of it in the disengage. And the re-engage from Vitality is just way too real here. This tower is finally going to go down without any minions, though. Maybe not quite yet. There we go.
Oh, curtain call comes down.
Oh, Reckless.
Two, three.
Boom. It's
ruining all
three.
The fun. I don't think they had any blue trinkets available at the time, so you have to step in. But again, Nuketuk is very confident in his ability to land these barrels here.
Said it, man. Best Gangplank in the West now. Febivin slides and glides his way out of the fight into the relative safety of the Sundisk. But Klai is not quite so lucky. He takes a ton of damage before having to flash away. Cabo Shard now tanking up.
Look at the mechanics. He's walking. Ah, that's just beautiful. Tank player walks in front of the bullets.
Get hit by skill shots?
Yeah. He's been there for a while.
Vitality, this would be number 3 for them. They do pick it up. Well, Cabo Shard was getting a little greedy for blue buff and Spirit. The rest of Fnatic, they weren't confident in trying to take this one, so Vitality just grabs all they can. Fnatic now moving, though, for Kasing. Can't quite find him because of the flashes there. Curtain calls on the hunt, defensive for Yharnam. Cabo Shard in the middle. Febivin incredibly low. And now Vitality are trying to chase on this one. It is a hectic, chaotic chase. Klai flashes over the pit, but Cabo follows, and so does Shook. Fnatic still on the run. Nuketuk just waiting as he loads his barrel. Let's see what he can
take
down. Oh, my goodness! Yharnam gets a kill on the other
That was
side.
So smart. He uses the cast to fly towards Febivin. Makes Spirit help him. Oh, what a good play. And Cabo Shard, too. He waited for Klai to get close to the wall, then Twisted Advance gets carried over. Complete outplay here from Vitality in this fight.
Big, big play. 2-4-none, and that's going to be Baron time. Right now, Spirit's caught by the Dark Binding. Gamsu still trying to kill Kasing, and he actually does go down. Spirit bops him with the barrel, and now there's an answer kill, though. Nuketuk has turned it on, and he finds Spirit. Gamsu trying to run away, but nowhere to go. That's a double kill for the Gangplank, and 4 Fnatic members are down.
Fnatic was doing a good job before, just kind of delaying the game more and more, playing around this 1-3-1 split push. But once they lost another dragon, I feel like got a little bit too aggressive, maybe saying, guys, we actually have to do something. We're losing on dragons. They still have Baron control. So Febivin was the guy diving in for Kasing, which started the whole fight. And he was very low and just had to run away after he... The Kasing effect.
Kasing effect.
Sometimes it is very, very real. Spirit, though, is going to try to get some revenge. He knocks Kasing back in, but there's a teleport already on. And Klai was bound up. Shook now with Yharnam, turning back onto Gamsu. Emperor's Divide pushes a few back, but not nearly enough.
Oh,
everyone is just melting! Oh, my lord! Fnatic are just gone.
What an absolute slaughterhouse from every single angle. Somebody from Vitality steps in. Cabin Shard is unkillable in that fight. Fnatic Melt get aced. Vitality, yeah, 14-2. Completely different game.
GG, well played, boys. Vitality say we will not get swept away, and under the rug, they take themselves the Nexus turrets, take the Nexus, and we have a series on our hands.